Last night, at 11:30, the lighthouse received a distress call from the SS Maelstrom, 20 miles off the coast. Rescue crews arrived in a matter of minutes, but ended up coming back with empty hands. There was nothing but a wreck. The ship sunk in what felt like a matter of seconds. That's where we come in. They've ordered us to get to the bottom of this. Literally. But not all of us, of course. There's only one Poseidon armor for only one of us. And that means you. This is a simple mission, kid. Find the black box and bring it back up. Glad to see the camera feed is coming in crystal clear. Damn. That boat sure is a wreck. Take a look around. You should see your current objective being tracked. Head towards that indicator. I'll plot a course through here and update it as you go. Let's test it. Try pulling the lever by that door. Looks like it's Loctite too. There's no lever nearby. Let's see. There should be a way to get it open via a security room in the library one floor down. You could use the elevator shaft to get down to that level.
I could wander the upper deck for days, and then the ship for weeks, and I bet I'd always find something new. So I began to explore, making my way down floor by floor, until I bumped into him. Barnabas Sandmartin. Foolishly charming. He is absolutely perfect. I knew it the moment our eyes met. He fell in love with me, and I knew he was the one. I eagerly look forward to keeping him close to me. He will be ours.
Hear that. Absolute silence. The SS Maelstrom is dead in the water. But I don't care, because I've met Coraline. Yeah, I've had the pleasure of meeting her. God, her lips are scarlet red, and her smell. I can't stop thinking of her smell. We're going to see each other again. That's what she said. Her voice echoes in my head. So special.
Today, and I gladly reiterated them. I could feel my hooks growing deeper in him. My brothers and sisters have grown jealous of me, but what can I say? Blame destiny. I will squeeze my hold on him harder tomorrow. The ship is so silent with the power off, and save for the candles lining the halls, there's very little light when the night falls. The darkness is beautiful. It embraces me like no other. Wrapped tight in the blankets, I am not cold. I am at home in the night. The way his muscles gleam in the moonlight, and how they move when he moves. Barnabas is the perfect specimen. He will be so proud. The host is almost ready.
Before.
me in my dreams, for the time has come. He has told me what is required for everything to go as planned. Barnabas' mission should keep him more than distracted as we prepare. These preparations are so much like cooking. The thumb knuckle of a chef, the lungs of a child. Harlow is bringing me the heart of one with an incurable disease. And Barnabas, the vessel. The screams of all these donors have been music to my ears. It hums to me in a strange, beautiful voice. Karishtu. Karishtu.
Karishtu.
Once you get in, those things will surround you real quick like, so work fast. The shutters and haul ass towards the bow. Sincerely, thanks.